let me introduce you to your new Defense Against the Dark Arts teacher, Gilderoy Lockhart, Order of Merlin, 3rd Class, Honorary Member of the Dark Force Defense League, and 5 times winner of Witch Weekly's Most Charming Smile Award. But I don't talk about that. I didn't get rid of the abandoned banshee by smiling at him. Now, be warned, it is my job to arm you against the foulest creatures known to wizardkind. You may find yourselves facing your worst fears in this room. Know that no harm can befall you whilst I'm here. I must ask you not to scream. It might provoke them!
Cornish pixies?
Freshly caught Cornish pixies. Laugh if you will, Mr. Potter, but pixies can be devilishly tricky little blighters. Let's see what you make of them. Yah! Come on now, round them up. They're only pixies.
My hair!
Pesky pixie, pester know me! Oh, I'll ask you two to just nip the rest of them back into their cage.
Hermione, we need to figure out how to stop the pixies. Immobilise! That will have to do for now. I have frozen time to buy some time to figure out a solution. I'll get my defensive magical theory textbook on jinxes and counter jinxes. Wait a minute, we can use the dataset from this book to figure out which spells to cast. Great idea, Hermione. Oh boy, this dataset contains a list of 15 magical creatures. Look, Harry, isn't that the robot giant doll from the Squid Game? Yeah, I thought it was destroyed. Medusa, Chimera, Demiguise, Imp. What spells can we try, Hermione? Well, there is Impedimenta, the impediment jinx to slow down or stop a creature. There is also Deprimo, you've used it before to blast holes in the ground. Yes, but I haven't tried it on a magical being. Perhaps Deprimo can be used to reduce strength? It's worth a try, isn't it? Hermione, shall we measure the spread of the dataset? Good point, Harry. We can calculate the variance, which is the average of the squared differences from the mean. The average of the squared differences from the mean? That's a lot of words! Look, it's really easy. Let's take a look at this example. Say we measure the strength of 7 creatures, and the data points are 4, 7, 10, 8, 5, 9, and 13. Nice! The mean value of this will be the sum of all the values divided by the number of creatures. That's right. In this case, the mean is 8. The next thing we need to do is to work out how far away the data points are from the mean. Woo! So the first data point is 4, and the difference with the mean is 4 minus 8, which is negative 4. Yes, we can work out the difference between each data point from the mean. I think I'm getting it so far, Hermione. So what do we do next? We square each of these values. So negative 4 multiplied by negative 4 becomes 16. Let's go ahead and calculate the square of each value. Because we are squaring these values, all of the values will end up being positive. We cannot get a negative variance value. That's right, Harry. We then add up all these squared values together, and this gives us a value of 56, which is the sum of squares. For the final step, we need to divide this value by the number of data points in our sample. We have 7 samples, but we need to subtract 1, and doing so will give us 6. We divide 56 by 6, and this gives us a variance of 9.33. Why do we need to subtract 1? The sample size minus 1 is known as Bessel's correction. It is used when calculating variance for a sample in order to correct for bias. Oh, I get it now, Hermione. So we can try to figure out whether Impedimenta or Deprimo is effective in reducing the strength of the magical creatures? Yep, let's start by comparing the difference in strength of the two groups before they were subjected to Deprimo or Impedimenta. We can use the t-test function on the strength before variable. That's right. The p-value is 0.68, which is higher than 0.05. This means that the two groups are not significantly different. In other words, before they were subjected to the spells, they had similar strengths. We can also check whether there is a significant difference between the variance of the strength of the creatures before the spells were cast. I'm glad you're paying attention, Harry. Let's check for the difference in variance using the F-test. We can run the F-test using the var test function. The p-value is greater than 0.05 again, meaning that the variances in the two groups are not significantly different. That is right. Prior to casting the spells, the two groups have similar characteristics. So any subsequent difference between the two groups can be attributed to the effect of the spells. Ooh, I can't wait to find out whether there's a difference between the primo and impedimenta. Alright, so the difference in strength before and after the spells is shown in the variable strength difference. Let's run a t-test on strength difference. Nice! This time, the p-value is way below 0.05. This means that the changes in strength after casting the spells were significantly different. Yes, we can conclude that the deprimo and impedimenta spells do have different effects on the strengths of the creatures. And if we look at the mean values, creatures subjected to impedimenta experience a larger change in strength. So it looks like impedimenta is a better choice. Awesome! Can we also calculate the variance of strength difference? Yes, we can. We can use the var test function again. Interesting. So the p-value is below 0.05. Therefore, the variances of change in strength between the two groups were significantly different. That's right. The primo and impedimenta spells do affect the variance of the change in strength. It's getting out of control, Hermione. Do something! Impedimenta!